Hey gang, it's Martin here again with CornerringUSA.com. So I've gotten a lot of questions surrounding ring sizing machines, which one I use and certain techniques involved in expanding and of course reducing the coin. So it'll be kind of a two-part video here. Not so much that I'm showcasing mine in particular, but I do just want to give it a couple minutes that I think it deserves because it's a really great ring sizing machine. But more importantly, I've got a couple things I want to show you, mainly a trick that I found using none other than this eraser, but I'll get to that in a second. So the ring sizing machine that I have is called Durston. It's an English brand, and it's from a website, the company riograand.com, and I'll have some information up about that in a little bit. But the first thing I wanted, you can see at the bottom of the ram here that is used on the reducing plate to reduce the coins. Again, this is the reducing plate that can accept and size up to 50 cent half dollar pieces for reduction. I'm going to try to zoom in here so you can hopefully at least just see what area I'm working on. You might be able to see that thin little strip right there on the bottom of the ram head. It looks like a little gray strip right there. That's actually the tape, the friction-resistant tape that you see up here on the expanding mandrel that I have that protects the detail of the coins, and that is to put it on the bottom of the ram head here, because this actually is coated from the factory. It's like a, I wouldn't say a rubber coating, it might be like a heat-treated rubber coating, but it degraded over time on mine. And it's not that big of a deal, but I've had some people ask me, how do I protect the coin while it's being reduced on the ring sizing machine? So if you are reducing, and here's a 50 cent piece here, Benjamin Franklin half dollar, just by bringing the ramrod up and down, of course, it's going to be protected. Again, the idea here is to keep the metal on metal contact to a minimum. Obviously, when you're using the reduction dies, you're going to have some metal on metal contact, but of course it's only going to be the edge. But this is a cool little tip that I wanted to pass on as well, because I've used it a few times now for a couple days and I think it's awesome. Came out, the rings are great. Not that I had a huge issue like I said before, but again, you know, the reeded part of the coin, something that we want to protect, at least that's the goal. So I find that tape really works well. I'm going to go ahead and pan out here. And the next topic I want to bring up here is the eraser. So what I found when I'm expanding the coins on the expanding mandrel, particularly with the larger size coins like the Morgan Silver Dollar, the Peace Dollar, and especially the American Silver Eagle, what I do with this piece of eraser is I take out the reducing wheel, the reduction plate, I take my eraser and actually just stick it in between the pin and the bottom backside end of the ring sizing machine. So I kind of get a good idea of what that looks like right there. Nothing fancy, nothing special. But the key is when I'm actuating the arm on my ring sizing machine for the purpose of taking a coin, particularly the larger ones, the half dollars, the dollars rather, and so forth, by having this eraser here, it allows me to drop the ram lower. I don't know if you can see that. It can actually drop lower than it would had I kept the reduction wheel in place. And why that's key, and this is really the key here, is if you can catch that, the pin that goes up and down right there, let me take that off so you can see, actually allows the pin to drop further down, into the expanding mandrel. The reason that that comes into play is that you can actually get more grip, you get more of a bite, if you will, when you're expanding your coin, particularly the larger ones. As you can see, it drops a little bit better. Gives more play for the arm than if you had the reducing wheel in place. So that dropped it a couple sizes at least. So that's just a little trick. The next thing here I have is, you might have noticed, a piece of PVC pipe. And of course, has a dual purpose here in my opinion. The first thing I do is just put it up on top. When I'm not using the ring sizing machine, I do have some shelving above with some items that I wouldn't want to fall down on top of the mandrel, top of the splines rather, so the PVC pipe works for that. And if you can also see, as you're reducing or expanding these coins, you can see some of the buckling there. Hopefully the camera will catch that. You can see some of the lines that naturally are going to form on this adhesive tape, this impact resistant tape. So one of the things that I do is I simply just grab the butt end of the PVC pipe with both hands and just work my way up and down the expanding splines. Go all the way around, and it does a pretty good job at getting rid of the majority of those buckles. And of course, over time, you're going to have to replace these. That's something that I found that works pretty well. So back to the Durston. You know, this is certainly more of the Cadillac, if you will, of ring sizing machines. There's a lot of them out there that you can get for about half the price, $150 to $200, $250. This is the Durston. I've got the information here for you guys. I'm gonna go old school again. You can see there's the website, riogrande.com. And I hope you like my rendition of the search box. If you're interested in looking and seeing and getting more information about this particular ring sizing machine, that's the part number, 112066. It's the Durston Ring Stretcher and Reducer. Currently priced at $407, I'm assuming, obviously, shipping, and if your state is one of them, like mine is here in California, you're gonna have to pay sales tax. You know, the main thing here with the ring stretcher and a reducer, you know, obviously the handles, that's the weak point on them, if you will. But if you don't wanna spend the $400 or $500, you can certainly, like I said, buy one of those, pick them up for $150, $200. You might even be able to go on Craigslist or find it used somewhere. You know, but the key is with the larger coins, like the Morgan Silver Dollar, and if you have the reduction dies, of course, it's the tremendous amount of pressure that it takes to initially, you know, both fold and in particular to reduce the Morgan Silver Dollar, the Peace Dollar, the American Silver Eagle. That's really one of the main issues when it comes to the ring sizing machine, you know, is the reduction part of it that makes it, I don't say difficult, but you know, you definitely have to have reduction dies that are polished, and also you're gonna wanna use some type of lubricant. I'd spoken about this on a previous video, you know, but I've got something here, same company from Rio Grande called Burr Life. Looks like candle wax. I mean, you could probably even use candle wax. Another thing that I use as well, sometimes just a silicone spray, that works really good as well. It's to keep the friction down. Another good option for you, and I'll kind of pan over here so you can see the other tool that I'm a pretty big fan of, that is the Arbor Press. I can zoom in there. This is my 1-ton Arbor Press with my long handle modification that I talk about in another video. I've got the steel plate on there as well as the urethane pad, and that's mainly just to protect the bottom of the reduction die. You know, but I'm a fan of this as well because this, the Arbor Press, is also a great way to go ahead and reduce the coin, especially the larger sized coins, the Morgan, the Peace Dollar, again, the American Silver Eagle. So I hope that that kind of answers some questions about the you know, ring sizing, ring stretching techniques. You know, again, this little technique with the eraser, like I said, just put it at the bottom there, take your wheel out. Works really well in giving you extra leverage here by allowing the pin to drop a little bit further than it normally would. And that's kind of the key in this. I'm gonna try this again and hope that my camera doesn't flip over. But again, you can see that it actually allows it to drop further down and actually compresses and brings these six individual splines as close together as possible. So there is actually, like I said, there is a difference. If you put your reducing wheel back on, bring it up, you'll actually see, and you go all the way down as far as you can because it's hitting the top of the reduction plate, there's the pin. And you can see the little lines there all around. It's not quite touching. I just like the eraser because it has that quality where it kind of springs up and down. But look how far down that pin drops. You can see that. Probably goes down a good 3/4 of an inch. And actually brings these splines a little bit closer together. So I found that to be very effective with not just the larger coins, but even with the half dollars that I'm using this ring sizing machine for. So again, Martin here with CoinRingUSA.com. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Go ahead and subscribe down on the lower right-hand corner. Click there if you haven't already. Go ahead and like and share this video with others. Keep sending the questions, guys. I love them. Again, CoinRingUSA@AOL.com is the email address that you can use, or you can feel free to post a question on any of the videos that I have. I do my best to check them and get back to people. So check that out. And that's pretty much it for this video installment of the Coin Ring Making A to Z series. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and we'll see you on the next video. Take care.